Let's continue coding our mail script. So we've got the brows working fine, the eyes are working fine as well, which is great. We've got to do it for the rest of our curves here. So let's go and find, see what we've got left. Okay, we've obviously got the cheeks. Let's do the cheeks. All right. Sorry, I just had to select that to make sure I have it. All right, we'll do the cheeks now. Same deal as before. I'm going to copy the string. Let's call this cheek one right. I'll start with the right this time. All right. I'm not worried about the vertex number yet. I'll just put that there. Cheek one right, cheek two right. So one will be down here, two will be up here. It's a weird way I put it. I know. That's just... Anyway. I'll put two and then one. We'll start from the top, down the bottom. All right, great. Let's go to the next one. And then we'll also create the float value for our cheeks as well. Same deal. Copy and paste onto the appropriate areas. This one might be a bit different, so I'm going to select cheek to right vert. Okay, so that's the one up here. Cheek to right vert. This will be the translate, and I'm going to copy and paste this to the next one. Great. All right, so same deal as the brow. We're going to grab the brow three right, so the eyelids are pretty much done, and we'll leave them there. So this will be the cheek. Cheek one, or cheek two right. I'm trying to be consistent with the way I've done this. And as before, we need the master curve, which is cheek to right. You can select the name and then just copy that name when it's popping up in the script editor. And we'll just replace the top one, right? We're going to move it up to cheek to right translate, or trans in this case. Okay, so those are our three vector coordinates for that particular vertice. For the vertex, cheek to right vert. So we're selecting the vertice, by the way. Then we'll select the cheek name, which is this one. Replace that. So you select add the group on top of the vertice there. Normal constraint, all good. And then finally, we select the constraint to, the normal constraint to delete it. Of course, we rename the appropriate areas here. So cheek to right should be working fine. We're going to select that. Copy and paste it into my notepad and execute. Okay, we have one issue here. It's not coming up. Oh, that's why, it's because it's been locked onto the top over there. So we have to change the vertice number. It's my bad. We'll find the vertice number, which is here. And the number is 1172. So cheek to right 1172. Okay, again, let's copy and paste. Well, let's execute. And there you go. It's working now. Okay, let's work on the number one, the cheek, the first cheek. So same deal as before, copy and paste the cheek right. So cheek one right, this will be cheek one right. It's a lot of copying and pasting, as you would notice, which makes it so much easier than typing it in manually, which is always a good thing, always a good thing. Cheek one right will be this one, I believe. So 1532. 1532. Copy, paste. All the code is correct. Go ahead and play. Execute. Okay, we've got an issue again. Let's try it again. It's not showing up. So the vertices are fine. Translate is fine. The code may be wrong. Down over here, what do we have? Cheek one right group. Let's go ahead and just copy that whole name just to be safe. I don't have time to manually check it myself. Cheek one right is fine. That's fine. I'll just do that again as well. Okay, normal constraints. That's fine as well. All right, something's wrong. Let me put it over here, 1186. So 1186. Ah, I see. I got that wrong. So our float was incorrect. It was cheek to right. So that's working now. Let's go ahead and, well, let's test it to make sure it's working. And there we have it. That's better. Okay. All right, let's do the other side. Again, pasting it into the code into my notepad. Let's do the left side of the cheek. Same deal as before. Copy and paste the working code and just change the appropriate so-called names or whatever whatever that may be. Right, I'm going to find the vertices numbers, so it will be this one, and I believe it's this one. So 173 for number 2, 173, and 187 for number 1. Oh, wait, no, sorry, 173 for number 1, that's 173, 187 for number 2. Same deal with the translate. Go ahead, paste. Cheek one left. And I think I forgot to do it on the top one. Nope, I didn't. That's fine. Cheek one right, cheek two left. Great. Over here, select the cheek, the code, and just copy and paste. So by now, you probably would have gotten an idea of how this is going to work. And if you already have an idea, that's great. So feel free to skip ahead. All right, I'm going to continue with the cheeks here. So replacing right with left. And I like to do it manually just to make sure I kind of get it all right and get an idea of the whole code, so to speak. Allows me to be intimately familiar with what I'm doing. That's more of a work style. You don't have to do it the way I'm doing it. So again, work style, different for every single person. Great. Copy, paste that into Notepad just to save it. Let's go ahead and execute to make sure that code is working, in which it is. Let's do the nose. I'm going to go ahead, put the nose here. So this will be nose one left. Nose one. Oh, we'll just call it nose. Nice and easy. And then nose, the vertices number is number 1. And that's the nose vert. We need to find the world translate of that nose, like so. And like the eyes, because I've already oriented all the joints forward anyway, I don't need to do any of the normal constraints. If anything, I probably don't want to ever do that. So I'm just going to go and grab the eyelid code. And we'll call this the nose. So nose. Alright, so we select the nose code or the prefix. So nose, group. And this one will just be nose for the rest of them. Okay, same as what we've been setting the float value to be. Or the float string. Play, execute. Okay, something's not matching, which is not good because I don't remember what I called my nose. What did I call my nose? Nose group. Okay, I didn't rename the nose properly. That's my problem, which is very frustrating. So we've got the nose bone. Go one. Had to fix this. So frustrating. Okay, there we go. That's the nose. So the nose name was correct. It just was. So dumb of me to not fix that. So the naming convention was actually not consistent at all. So that's another thing we've got to keep in mind. All right. Also make sure the group node is actually correct. All right, so that's good. Let's go back up. So the nose, copy paste, test. Great, it's working. Let's do the rest of the lips. Lips, very simple. It's the exact same principle as what we've done with the brows and the cheeks. Okay? So I'm going to go and create the string group here. And I like to have those enter spaces here, those paragraphs. Just makes it a bit easier for me. And there were 8 lip nodes. I'm going to call this lips top center. Copy that. Lips BTM center. So these will be just the lips, the top and bottom, and the rest will be left and right. Okay, I'm going to separate them again to make it easier. And that comment there will also make it easy for me to see. So we'll have lips, one left, or 3 left, again, being consistent. Right, I would say. Lips, 2 right, lips, 1 right. Done. This one, lips, 3 left. Lips, 2 left, lips, 1 left. Let's find the values first before we move on, in case we lose track of what we're trying to do. So I'm going to get the top and the bottom. You can see it's 23 and 62 respectively. So 23, 62. Let's do the right side, which will be 1, 2, no, sorry, my apologies. Nope, that is correct. No, sorry, that is actually incorrect, because I want to get this edge loop here, so I selected the wrong edge loop. So 61 and 62, so top will be 61. I got the wrong one. Okay, and 62 is the bottom lips. Okay, great. So right. You know, remember, it starts... How did it start again? I can't even remember anymore. Let me go back to my trusty little thing here. So lips top center. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So it goes from the top, which is great. Right. Component mode. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. Let's put that in. 1, 2, and 3. All right, just make sure it's the correct vertice value or the string value. So lips 3 right, and unfortunately I did it the wrong way. Let's do that again. So I'm just going to reverse it now. So I should really slow down, because I put 3, 2, 1. I really don't know why, but whatever. Never mind. Must have stemmed from the browse. That's okay. 3, 2, 1. All right, great. This will be 1, 2, and 3. So that's 3, 2, 1, by the way. My apologies. I am trying to be consistent. Sometimes my code doesn't really make sense, but that's okay. It'll stretch your thinking. At least you go, now I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to confuse us. That's actually not what I'm trying to do, but what I'm trying to do is, well, just be consistent with my naming conventions, the method, and the order of my coding. I'm going to expand this a little bit so we can get a better context here. That's okay, you can use that to your advantage, because if I do things in a weird way and you can still keep track, then, well, your brain will keep track as well. You'll be like, oh, I see what you're trying to do. You're very tricky. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm not trying to be tricky here. I'm just a little bit disorganized. All right, lips 3 right. And like so. So we've got the float vectors for our left and right keys. So let's go 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Left, left. Okay, 2, 1. Great. Like the cheeks and the brows, we need to use the full normal constraint. So not the nose, let's go ahead and do lips top center. ellipse, top, center. Well, I believe is ellipse, center, top. I'm not familiar. I'm not totally sure. Give me 1 second. Okay, so the master curve is ellipse, center, top. Unfortunately, I spelled that wrong. So I'm gonna have to rename this. So select ellipse, center, top, the group. Okay, which is great. Let me just double check. So ellipse, top, center. Okay, that's gonna be a bit confusing, but that's all right. At least I can keep that in the back of my head. So this will be the ellipse, top, center. And as you're coding, over time, you'll be able to mentally simulate all of those weird connections in your brain. Okay, since the computer does operate a bit differently. And you can visually just see how the code sort of will function, where the objects are and such. It takes a bit of time, so that's okay. But it's just something I wanted to point out, that people, when you haven't done coding before, you tend to be intimidated by all of this stuff. All right, I'm going to test the top center of the lip. Copy and paste and execute. All right, so that's working fine. Let's do the rest of them. Lips top center. Let's do the bottom, BTM. So lips center BTM. BTM, just replace the top with bottom. Very simple. Same with this one here. So I have inconsistent naming conventions on that. But anyway, whatever. All right, let's test this again. Great, bottom's working. Let's do the right side. So lips, 3 right. Same deal as before. Lips, 3 right. And I'm hoping that's the name of the master curve. Let me just double check. Lips 3 left, lips 3 right. Okay, yep, that's correct. So that's good. And I think we can just do the rest of these lips pretty quickly. I'm hoping you guys can see that. I might make it a little bit larger, so that you can at least understand what the heck is going on here. So I'm just holding control and the mouse wheel, basically, so you can middle mouse wheel in or out. All right, lips, bottom center. That is so much easier to see. I have no idea why I didn't do this earlier. That's okay, we're having fun here, aren't we? Aren't we? We are indeed. All right, lips to right. Again, because we've already know this code works, we just need to change certain values to match the appropriate naming. And that is why you do not ever use the name such as untitled object, because it will drive you crazy when you get to this particular stage, or if you ever do this. There is just no way anyone is going to be able to sift through the garbage. So we want to, anytime we create our objects, we just want to assume that other people are going to open our project and work on it. So you want to make it easy for them to see and understand. All right, so lips 3 left, 3 left. And I'm doing something really risky right now because I haven't tested the right side yet, so I don't know if I've screwed up the naming convention, but I guess we'll see. That's okay. It's not exactly a hard or difficult thing to do by just testing it before you continue. But anyway, I like to try and do things in big chunks. Hope you guys are having fun with this. Coding is certainly a good break from... Oh dear, I put that as 1. That should be number 2, should it? Alright, I'll put it 2. So coding is a good break from all this modeling and texturing, we haven't got to that point yet. But all this rigging and all this other stuff. It's just a good refresher. Something refreshing to do. Lips 1 left, and we should be done. All right, I'm going to copy, paste that into my notepad again. Let's test it just to make sure it works. Execute. Beautiful. So that's fantastic. So this code now does everything for us. All right? Well, almost everything. But it does it pretty well, nevertheless. Okay, a couple of exceptions. What about the ears and the jaw? Well, this is where human input is required. What we've done is we've created a proportion system to allow us to work on, well, all the important stuff. Actually, there's one more thing that we can do to get the mail script to do, and that's the eyeball controllers themselves. I'm going to go ahead and do that. So the same with the eyeballs. It's the same as what we've done with the eyelids. So top eyelid, bottom eyelid. I'm going to need eyeball or eye. Eye left and eye right. I'm hoping that's the naming convention I've used. Yes, eye left and eye right, which is good. That's what we want. And because it's the same as eye left and eye right, well, the same as the eyelids, we don't really have to change anything. Just going to make sure we got that correct, which is good. Okay. Same with the float. We need the float as well. And again, I'm going to put this just underneath there. So eye left. Okay, so that's for our eyeballs. And it's the same as the nose and the eyelids. We don't need to do any of the normal constraint stuff. Let's just go ahead and put eye controller right. We're going to select, we'll have to go down actually and find that eye. Because I can't remember. Okay, so the eye group is this one. So eye left group. It's actually eye right group. So eye left group. Just go ahead and replace that. There we go. EB, which is eye bone. It will be eye right trans. And that's basically it. Do the same for the left. Copy the controller. Well, the code, put left, just replace left with right, really. There we go, great. Whoa, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's test it out. Just scroll up and execute. Again, copy and paste that code into Notepad. There we have it. Now remember, it's because we've already applied the eye constraint, these eyes will be aiming down. Right? And the eye constraint is right here. But the user can manually just push it up here themselves, okay? To appropriate it for whatever reason they want. What about the other stuff? Well, this is the same deal when it comes to the UI controller as well, so they can do that. What about the other stuff? Well, this is going to depend on how you've set the system up, but because I've set the system up in such a slightly odd way, it might be a bit tricky. What I want to do, however, is manually move this up into position. So I can go ahead and do that using just the normal movement things and just apply it to the ears. The reason why I want to do this is because, you know, rigs vary. There may be differences in, you know, their functionality and such. The jaw, same deal, except the jaw, I need to grab the jaw group as well. So the jaw, exact same deal. We'll go to the front or the side profile and we'll move it up manually to the mouth here. Okay, and obviously you want to figure out where you want to do that or where you want to actually put it. Now once that's done, once you've applied all of that in, you know, the curves and whatever, we need to determine how we put this back into the master curve, which is that one right there. So the master curve, again, we have to manually put it up like so. Or even better, we can already, I'm just going to undo that for a second. I'm going to grab the ears, move them down there. I might just approximate their position. And I might grab the ears and move it into the master curve. So let's grab the ears, middle mouse drag into the master curve. So now the master curve can be used to reproportion that. And same thing with the jaw. Remember, the jaw, we can manually adjust it. But if I wanted to sort of make it work, I can just do this like that. Maybe I can move the jaw up. So open the master curve, just manually move the jaw up slightly. There we go, great. Okay, so the process will be as follows. We've got the mel script that does all of that there, and we've got the curve that appropriates the jaw and the ears. Now the ears you can also adjust, the jaw is looking fine as well. But I want to bring all of those groups, all the ones outside of that curve, back into the curve itself. So now the curve can control everything, all right? And we can do this. Let me just copy and paste this again back into my notepad. Okay, so you can see my notepad has everything. And I want this to be the last, well, the final function of this code. And the final function will be finalize rig, put all appropriate curves or control curves into master curve. And very simple, we've done this in the first video when I was showing you guys how to do it. Let's go and select iAim, shift select all of those groups right there. Okay, and you can see the code is up here. So I'm going to go select R, just grab the bottom one because it's selected all of them. Put that there. Let's just paste it in there. It's a very, very long code, by the way, because it contains everything that we've selected. All right. And what do we want it to do? I'm going to control click master curve. So we select add. Let's put that in. And let's just parent it. So press P. And you can see the parent code is right there. Press P. And if you want to clean it off, I'm going to type in select CL or select clear. Or you can do it in here. Just click away and you can see select CL. We can just paste it in there. And that is basically it. That's basically how you create your facial proportions. So the facial rig is going to be as follows. Let's start from scratch. So this is number 47. I'm going to reload, so I'm not going to save. Well, before I do that, I should copy this code. So the process is as follows. You've completed your mesh and you've rigged him on your bipedal rig and he's ready to go. You want to add your facial rig now. Well, it's very simple. I've gone ahead and saved the face rig in a separate file. So only the face rig, no meshes and nothing else in there. It's nice and clean. Let's just drag and drop this into the scene. Now you have to use imagination that we've already got a bipedal rig. But the process will be like this. We'll grab the appropriate control curves. For example, the iAim and the UI system. And by the way, this is just how we've set up the code. Next, I'm going to grab my master curve and move that into position. And I'm going to go to my side view and just make sure the jaw is aligned properly. So I'm using the tongue as a reference right there. The ears are a little bit off. So I want to adjust this slightly. I'm going to go to my master group here. Scroll down all the way to my master curve, because that's where the ears are right now. And in the master curve, I'm going to select the ear groups, all four of them, the bones and the controls. And what I want to do, let's go to my side view and move it roughly into position. Once that's in position, we're ready to use our script. And the script will appropriate all the other controllers along our face. So I'll grab my script, which is in my notepad here, and it can be a text file inside a mail script folder that you can own. I'm going to copy that, go to my script editor, paste it, and execute. And that does everything for you. Your facial rig is now ready to go. Of course, you also need to parent this to the top of your bipedal rig of the head. And once that's applied, you're pretty much ready to start applying skin weights on your face. So it's a very simple process. This mel scripting isn't too difficult, as you've seen. Okay? Feel free to give that a try. And if you found it a bit hard to follow this, that's okay. Again, over time, you'll get used to it. You'll understand a bit more mel scripting and you can see how quick we can apply our facial rig. And you can get any other head rigs as well, or head meshes, and apply the same result. Okay, because it's just so simple. That's just how we've set it up. This will conclude the face rig stage. And in the next stage, we're going to get into something that's a lot more fun.